Hey everybody, this is Psych with Psych's Rex Banjo Kazooie Nuts and Bolts? What? Now I know you're probably saying like, wait a minute Psych, this game's all about like building your own vehicles, there aren't any like official type vehicles that are official. And I say, au contraire. Yeah, I know, it's kind of lame, but hey, I built one. I'm actually kind of pleased how this turned out. And I made it a monster truck because why wouldn't I? It's a red El Camino monster truck. And not to spoil anything, but this will not be the last time you see one of these type of vehicles in this series. Red El Camino monster truck type. Whoa, exciting! Also, I can turn the headlights on. Look at that. That's pretty cool. Anyways, yeah, this is Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts, obviously a game that's made famous for the fact that you can build your own stuff and then you go through all the levels and do challenges and blah 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 blah. Obviously, it's got a lot of flack for the fact that it's not a Banjo-Kazooie platformer, but you know what? I think it's okay. I honestly do. But then again, I also like games like Star Fox Adventures, so I'm clearly insane. But, you know, I really don't have a problem with this game. As you can see by Banjo, with his little, like, little jacket and shirt on. Oh, aren't you fancy? Yes, I have completed this game 100%. I've got as many trophies, or, no, wait. Well, okay, hold on. I have every TT trophy in this game. TT stands for Trophy Thomas, so I have every Trophy Thomas trophy in this game. And I also have as many achievements in this game that you can get by yourself, because that's my thing, including everything in Log's Lost Challenges. So, for all intents and purposes, I've completely completed this game. All the way. So I figure I'd just use this video as an excuse to show off Banjo Land, because this level's really cool. And also I get to show it off in an El Camino-style vehicle that I built. Anyways, what I really like about this level is it's obviously just a massive homage to every other level from the other two games, Banjo-Kazooie and Banjo-Tooie. For instance, here's the, I think it's King Sandybutt's Pyramid from Gobi's Valley. Let's see here. There's the igloo from Hellfire Peaks. That is supposed to be a recreation of Lago from Grundy Industries. That's a model of the Rusty Bucket from Rusty Bucket Bay. And what's funny is that the actual Rusty Bucket has two smokestacks, but this model has three for some reason. And also the little signpost says something about like how modern gamers are too much weaklings to handle the intricacies of the inner engine room of the of the original game, which I find funny. Let's see. Whoop, there's a penguin. See, that right there is the Salty Hippo from Treasure Trove Cove. That is the Alien Saucer from Jolly Roger's Lagoon. There's the Cactus of Strength from Witchy World. Here's what's left of the Snowman from Freeze Easy Peak. I just hit a penguin. Hope that's cool with everybody. Oh, well, there we go. Well, people would just stop leaving their penguins all over the place. I wouldn't just plow them over. Hold on, let me see if I can. Can you see it? There's supposed to be a stop and swap egg, the ice key, and a disc. I don't remember what that disc is, but it's supposed to be an homage to stop and swap. Whoa! Secrets revealed! Anyways, that little wooden thing right there is supposed to be tanked up from Bubble Gloop Swamp. Moving onward, hitting penguins. Because why wouldn't you? Oh, listen to that. Listen to that Rusty Bucket Bay music. Yeah. Here's Cheeto. Not the Cheeto, just, you know, like a recreation of Cheeto. Okie dokie. There's a whole bunch of stuff up here. There's the Golden Goliath. There's a cow. And right here is... That's Target Zan from Mayhem Temple. And then, obviously, the kickball stadium. Oh, I just hit a rabbit. Oh, I just hit a person. But this thing right here is supposed to be an homage to... Whatever. It's supposed to be an homage to the, like, the Stonehenge area of Mumbo's Mountain. Oh, come on now. Don't be like that now. Don't be like that now. Don't hate on me just because I had to make an El Camino / Ranchero style vehicle. Oh, well, there you go. See? Just throw in shade. Just throw in shade. Oh, hit a mouse. Here's basically one quarter of the mansion for Mad Monster Mansion, as well as the graveyard. Voila. Here's some gems and some tracks and some stuff from Glitter Gulch Mine. Let's see, what else we got here? Here is not anything. Oh, hi. Not anything in particular, but this trash can is filled with, oh, you little... I hate these things. Screw you. Can I, yeah. Get rid of you! It's a trash can filled with, grabbed by the ghoulies. Oh, wow, this is cool. I've seen these, but I guess I forgot about it. Big Al's Burgers and... thing of gum and then a can of guff beans. He took one. Look at that. Oh, that's lame. Took one of my headlights off. You jerk. Give me that back. Now I can see clearly now that the rain is gone. Actually, it has nothing to do with rain. It has to do with the fact that I have high beams. Anyways, back onto the tour. Here's a homage to Cloud Cuckoo Land. It's like, I think there's the cheese, and there's George, and the beehive, and all that sort of stuff. And then over here is an homage to Click Clock Wood. And some random things that don't mean anything. Right in front, right behind is a mouse that I just kind of shotgunned. But right in front of me, right there, you can see some spotted eggs, which I guess are supposed to be reminiscent of Terry's eggs from Pterodactyland. And finally on the tour, and dare I say, my favorite / least favorite part is Clanker from Clanker's Cavern. I don't know what to say. I'm sickened, honestly. I love the fact that he was in this game, but, like, why in this capacity? Why would you have to do that? Because you notice right here is just his head and, like, his lower jaw with some gold teeth. Some other stuff right there. There's, like, his midsection with the spinning blades. There's his tail. And then up there is his jaw. Which I don't understand. How? Wait a minute. How the? He's got teeth there, but then there's an upper and lower jaw there. Yeah, that makes sense. But anyways, I remember finding out about Clanker being in this game, and I was like, oh, that's so awesome! And then the first time I played Nutty Acres, which is the first level in this game, I was like, oh, I bet he's out in the water somewhere, and that would be so cool, and blah, 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 blah. But then I find out that It's like, basically the opposite happens. They take just this giant, majestic creature that was, you know, locked up in the first game. And they just like, oh, well, you know what? I'm not dealing, no, no. Oh, no, you don't. Oh, yes, you do. Okay, anyways. Oh, well, there we go. Into the water I go. This is, like, the least amount of good because my vehicle's not meant to get submerged. Let's see if I can... Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Come on. El Camino / Ranchero prevail. Yeah, Coop Utility. That's right. That's why it's called a utility. But it's also sleek and stylish like a coop. You see that? There's a perfect... They should have just used this video for their promotion of the El Camino / Ranchero back in the 50s. Come on, up on the tail. Yeah. Oh yeah, off-roading. Oh yeah, off wheels. Oh, come on. Oh, well, okay. Okay, maybe not. Maybe not. There we go. You know what? I'm okay. Screw it. I'm done with this area. I'm just gonna pay my respects to just. It's just like I'm so sorry this happened to you. I would have never had this happen to you, buddy. I feel your pain. High beams. Okay, I'm gonna off-screen to a different level to show off something that I think is kinda cool. I'll see you there in just a second. Okay, so I am here in Nutty Acres, and I figure I would show off this other El Camino / Ranchero style vehicle that I made. As you can see, it's yellow. That's pretty exciting. Oh yeah, and it's a freaking boat as well. I don't know if you can see this, but I got... Got propellers on the back and little floaties. So let's rock some boat. Wreck style boat. I'm so happy. I just off screen here just because the load times in this game are kind of bad. Also, I will say I am so happy that they finally something freaking allowed me to oh hold on now. Something freaking allowed me to call this the R/EC that it actually is, as opposed to like everything in my computer or everything. I'm just like, you know, it's R/EC, and they're like, well, you can't do that because you can't use slashes. I'm like, shut up. That's not what it is. Yeah, El Camino boat. What will I think of next? Wow. I know what I can think of next. Hold on. I know what I can think of next. El Camino submarine. You know, the physics... I don't know why. I just feel like I never appreciated this game for what it really, really was until this most recent time of me playing it. So this is really cool. Anyways, raise the Titanic. That's exciting. Anyways, I guess I could just talk about my experience with the Banjo Kazooie series. Obviously, I started with number one. I got that for the N64 back in the day, and I could never. I don't know if it was I couldn't, I just didn't ever get past Gobi's Valley, I think is the farthest I ever got. So, to me, like, Mad Monster Mansion, Rusty Bucket Bay, and Click Clock Wood, those were, like, the most incredible things ever. I was like, what? Those are some levels. And then when you finally do hit a whale, it's really satisfying. No, when you finally do get to them, it's like, wow, it's amazing. When I was younger, I just went through this phase where any platformer that I got, I just didn't really care about beating it. Also, I'm doing this. That's pretty cool. There we go. It worked even better! Okay, fine. I was trying to be cool. When I was younger, I just went through this phase where, like, with platformers, I just didn't care about completing it. I just kind of wanted to play it. So, like, Banjo Kazooie, Super Mario 64, and Gex Enter the Gecko were the three that, right off the top of my head, I know I just didn't care about doing. I wonder if I can. Come on. Is this actually gonna work? No. Oh, give me strength. The heck? That was so weird. There you go. Anyways, I just didn't care about getting 100% in the game. Certainly, like, not like now. I mean, if I can't 100% a game, I'll go insane. Oh, I think I got it. There we go. Gears, take me away. So at the time, you know, like, Super Mario 64 never got 120 stars. Gex Enter the Gecko never got all the red remotes. And certainly never got any of the gold ones. And then Banjo-Tooie came out, and when I was younger, Banjo-Tooie, anytime I would play that game, I was so intimidated by it. I would have to play it with a guide. Like, I would have to be able to know where everything was. Otherwise, it was just like, I couldn't do it. It was just the thought of it was way too hard for me. Of course, now I can blow through the entire game without a guide. Oh, okay. Yep. There we go. That was comfortable. Kind of. Oh, well, okay. This just got interesting. Yeah! Banjo Bond. There we go. Okay, enough dicking around in a boat. I have an even better idea. Yeah, that's right. El Camino that can fly! And is purple. Yeah, is pretty sweet. But anyways, very intimidated by Banjo-Tooie. So I never played it without a guide. But now, it's not even a concern. I love Banjo-Tooie. I actually like Banjo-Tooie more than Banjo-Kazooie. But anyways, that's pretty much going to be the end of this video. I'm going to do one more thing. Well, possibly. I'm gonna do one more thing and then I'll be done with this Sykes Rex. It's kind of dragging on a bit and I'm just kind of dicking around. Can I do it here? I need to find a good spot to park it. I mean land it, because I am a Helicamino. Oh my god, that just came to me. Helicamino. I am the master of words. I guess I'll just park it on this thing. Oh, no, 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 nope, nope, nope. There we go. Hop out. Change vehicle. Let's see here. Okay, so here I am, literally on top of the world. I mean, look at that. That's scary as hell, actually. So I'm going to finish this video off with the most appropriate thing that I can think of doing. I'm gonna take this, and I'm gonna just kinda be like, interesting. I'm gonna go after it. See you guys next time. Yeah, I'm leaving it off here. See you guys next time. Psych Rex. Oh yeah, by the way, dank bus opportunity.